3. Life was born only for Earth's revolution. As explained earlier, humans are the cells of the Earth born for the evolution of the Earth, which make up the Earth with all the animals, plants, and microbes on Earth, as if so many of those cells were born and died, taking charge of the activity in the human body during the course of one's lifetime. If human differs from other creatures, it has no difference except the higher evolutionary level than other creatures. However, human is born with a sense of limitation that can play a role for evolution while managing his body and live a competitive life with the surrounding beings while recognizing the surroundings and solving the physiological requirement. But in order to reach a higher level of consciousness that can be seen at the Earth level or the principle of the larger universe, it evolves through mastering the principles of the universe one by one through tens of thousands of years of foolish and painful life. In the end, human beings are the ones who play a part in the evolutionary activities of the Earth by achieving human completion and the ultimate emancipation by reaching the holistic concept. This evolutionary process of humans through already known to this world by very few enlightened person has been approached in the form of religions, which are clerical or religious concepts that emphasize existing ethics and morality, so people could not be objectively and reasonably understood. But for the first time in human society, omniology has made it easy and interesting to understand the principles of the universe that was so difficult to learn by simply and clearly explaining the principles of the universe as a scientific system. Thus, by clearing up the slow evolutionary process that mankind has achieved in its long and painful life, and now by living a vibrant evolutionary life, we have come to a new era of human culture in which Earth's evolution takes place quickly and in which the happiness and achievement of mankind are enjoyed in a different way than in the past.